Hello and welcome to Tramad All Nights. How you doing, you big fucking loyalist terror suspect? You big gun-running bisexual down the front here. How you doing, man? That's a face I've only ever seen before on a fucking Toby jug. Oh, but I hadn't even seen him there. You've quantum leaped to be with us tonight from the Victorian prison system. How's life been since Erasure split up? How's that? A cross between Andy Bell and a pickled fetus in a fucking jar. Like a child's drawing of a dead baby. How you doing? Why have you got your jacket spread over your boss? Oh, I see. Because you've got your trousers pulled up so tight you've got one of those ball vaginas. How you doing, man? What's your story, man? Let's find out a bit about you. What do you do?
Fireman.
You're a fireman? In a Village People tribute band. With the Pope over, didn't we? The Pope said he loved being in Britain, as most of his Nazi pals only ever made it as far as France. Very environmentally friendly, the Pope Mobile, as it runs on the tears of abused altar boys. I should point out, the Pope isn't a paedophile, he's a paedophile facilitator. Met Susan Boyle, what a meeting that must have been. Two people who look unconvincing in a dress. He thought she was there to be cured. No, he said he loved meeting Susan Boyle. It took him back to his youth when he was being trained to kill the mentally ill. Pope says that condoms don't stop the spread of AIDS. Someone should tell the fucker that he's putting them on wrong. To me, religion, all religions are just a list of things that autistic people said thousands of years ago that happened to get taken seriously. On a Friday, you can only eat fish, nothing but fish. Brilliant, I'll write it down. Religion's just what we thought before we understood what mental illness was. A bush talked to me. Brilliant, what did it say? What did the bush say? Let's live our lives by what the bush said, you stupid fucking cunts. I mean, I think back to priests when I was a wee boy. They had a sort of Asperger's equality to them. They never met a witty priest. So I was doing an exorcism. I was telling the devil to come out of the boy. When the devil made the very good point that as a priest, I'd probably been inside more children than he had. Touché, Satan. Do you remember that show Knight Rider? We started thinking his car wasn't talking to him. He was just quite seriously mentally ill. Lighten things up a bit. A wee jokey joke. Everyone likes a wee jokey joke, don't they? Here we go. When I was a wee boy, I had a dream that I was eating a giant marshmallow. And when I woke up, I was being sexually abused. What do Japanese people call their japsai? My eye. Britain's been complicit in torture. I've never understood why Al-Qaeda don't just employ sadomasochistic perverts.
We tried pulling his fingernails out, sir, but he came.
Did you try the ball clamp on him? Yeah, he brought his own. The scaremonger we're supposed to be scared of, the pants bomber. Supposed to be scared of that guy. Tried to set off a bomb in his pants. I wish he'd done it just so I could know that he was up in heaven with 72 virgins but had blown his cock off.
If they'd done it on Ryanair, everyone would have been delighted to get blown up and actually land closer to their fucking destination. Ryanair have a thing now where they're going to charge people £80 for a suitcase and £1 to use the toilet. I've got a solution. Buy your suitcase its own seat on the plane for a fiver, then take a shit. Jeremy Kyle, that gets me, man. They round up the audience for that show by firing tranquilizer darts into farm foods. It's always scumbags, isn't it? There's never an episode called I Wanted to Go to Tuscany, You Swine. I'd like to see him come back with the DNA test results, my mate, and go, I've got your DNA test results here. You're not actually human. Turns out you're a rare breed of fucking cabbage. TV, man, how low is it going to sink? I fully expect to switch on the telly in a couple of years, see someone going, my name's John Leslie, this is a Viking longship, and you're watching The Story of Rape. Going to have product placements on ITV now. I think they should blackmail companies by threatening to do negative product placements. Sarge, we caught a paedophile. Really? What was he doing? Eating Walker's crisps. I saw a show the other night. They're cutting open these giant animals. They go, oh, look at this giraffe. It has an incredible number of neck vertebrae. Of course, it's got an incredible number of neck vertebrae. It's a fucking giraffe. What are you expecting to find inside it? A horse with a periscope. You see that guy that died in the luge in the Winter Olympics? Bit of a silver lining. He's coming back next year to compete in the skeleton bobsleigh. Do you watch Wimbledon? Do you watch the wheelchair tennis? They're fucking brilliant at tennis. It's really compelling. But why during the break did they make them go over to the side? They're already sitting down. How much of a rest do they need, the fucking lazy bastards? I always like the grunting in the tennis, putting each other off with the grunting. Should we bring that into the snooker? John Parrott, 12. It's good that the lady tennis players grunt. I'd feel weird if it was me sat at home on my own doing it. You know what they should do? They're always arguing about the ball going out, aren't they? What they should do is take up all the grass at the side of the court. Everything outside the lines should get replaced with Velcro. So when the ball goes out, it just fucking sticks. And every so often, Venus Williams falls over and spends 20 minutes having her muff cut free with scissors. I like that scandal in the rugby. Did you see the guy that hid the blood capsule in his mouth so he could pretend it was injured? I thought he should have hidden it up his arse and done it in the scrum. Oh, you dirty bastard! Send him off, ref! Yellow card, they fucked us! Goodbye, fatherfuckers! Whoa! I can't tell you what a pleasure it is to be appearing on what is basically a children's TV channel looking like an old fucking tramp. How you doing? How you doing, Gigantor? How you doing, big man? Fucking hell, you've not just fought bigger men than me, you've shat bigger things than me. How you doing, big fella? You know, that's a sinister fucking head you've got there. The only way your picture's ever going to appear in the paper is above the caption, police suspect the real figure may be much higher. Are these people with you? Or have they just been drawn into your orbit? How you doing, man? What's your story? You've got very negative body language there, and you just did a sort of shrug of, I don't know what my story is. To be honest, Frank, I only came to a couple hours ago in a skip with no trousers, covered in seven different types of semen. How you doing? Are you his girlfriend?
No.
No. Very definite no there. Do you know him?
Yeah.
Outreach worker? Oh, yeah. What's happened with the hair here?
What?
I really, I don't mean it to sound horrible, but it's a bit like Boy George in a chemotherapy wig. Sorry, there was no way that wasn't going to sound horrible. It just
It sounded horrible because it was horrible. That's went wrong there, hasn't it? Do you know that half the people in Britain who give Botox injections aren't qualified in any way? Now, the people that have been victims of these guys are absolutely shocked and horrified, although you wouldn't know it to look at them. I say, women, if you don't want to have wrinkles, put on weight. Put on a couple of stone. That'll take up the slack. Why be a raisin when you could be a grape? What I'm into myself sexually is leather. I say leather, I mean older women. Britain's oldest woman to gave birth recently. She was 63. I'm sure that was actually a magical moment. I'd have loved to have been there when her dust broke. Can't be easy getting up in the middle of the night, age 63, to change a soiled nappy. Especially now she's got a baby. Still, it must be nice being able to breastfeed it without having to lift it out of the cot. I couldn't have sex with someone that old because they might die. They might die during sex. And I don't know that I could trust myself to stop.
This Christmas, meet four children from Glasgow and join them in their discovery of a magic wee hing.
Welcome, children.
What the fuck is that?
Children, what do you ask of me? A Christmas wish?
You do wishes.
Young sir, I do. Name your heart's desire, and with a sprinkle of moonbeams, I shall make your fondest dream come true.
Make your next-door neighbour have a black baby.
Well, I've got money on Celtic for the cup. Make Rangers fucking blind.
Just do it, you fucking wee dick. Dead leg.
You've shattered my hip. Oh, God. Please, no. I could make your toys come to life for an evening.
No, shag this rabbit.
Children, please. My apologies, Mrs. Rabbit. No. The shame.
Yes.
Children, please. No. No, please, children, no. Thank you, Lucy. You're very kind.
Just trying to make sure you're better. I bet my Christmas money you'll be able to fight off this dog.
Hey, Jesus Christ! Hey, shit!
Get the fuck off me!
Get off me! No! No! My face! My face!
This Christmas, experience the wonder of the magic wee hing.
I have mental health problems. There's a lot of stigma attached to mental health. A lot of people are unfairly stigmatised when their conditions allow them to lead perfectly normal lives. Who the fuck am I talking to? I'm you the fuck!
Okay, sweetheart. We're just cuddling.
Honey, we're just cuddling.
They stole my fucking dildo.
That's the one catchphrase we've got in the show. I'm going to show you heavy, father fucker. So we hope that catches on among little kids. The reason we say fatherfucker so much in this show is that you're not allowed to say motherfucker on TV, but no one seems to have thought about fatherfucker. My favourite thing on TV is those anti-drinking adverts. It's always like a drunk woman staggering about, or a drunk woman falling over. I always watch those and I think, that's right, there's drunk women out there. Better get my coat on. always practice safe sex myself. What I do is I hang about outside an STD clinic and chat up women who come out looking relieved. My favourite story ever is the Michael Barrymore story, because it just keeps coming back. You know, every so often the papers, or sometimes the police, will come out and go, perhaps we'll never truly know what happened on that night. Well, a dead guy's turned up full of drugs and spunk. I reckon I could take a fucking guess at it.
Oh, what could have possibly happened here? We've got a dead body with an arsehole like a vintage golf bag.
Thanks very much. That's the end of the show. You can all go and fuck yourselves till the same time next week. Good night.
How you doing, big chap? I like this hair and beard arrangement. Haven't you just escaped from a game of Guess Who? I'm sure my daughter created you with a magnet and some filings the other day. Is this your woman?
It is.
What first attracted you to the big chap? Gravity? What do you do?
I work for the council.
What do you do for the council?
Just admin.
Just admin?
Just admin. Yeah. Not important.
Nothing important. Move along, Frankie. Think that's going to work out for you, that strategy? I'll abuse you so badly you'll think I was a friend of the family. What area of council admin do you specialise in? So we can hate you in a specific way. Rather than the general way we're hating you at the moment.
Social work.
Social work. There you go, that's sharpened it up a bit, hasn't it? Have you got a net for stealing children? You have a slightly haunted look about you, do you know that? Slightly haunted, broken look. What do you hate most about life? Is it the fact that your dad fucked you, or the fact that you enjoyed it? Genuinely surprised I'm getting away with that, but there we go. Seem to be getting away with it. How are you doing, big man? You alright? What do you do?
Play football.
You play football professionally?
No.
Who for?
Dunfermline.
Not professionally. Roman Abramovich, he's a sinister fucker, isn't he? I think because Abramovich is so sinister, that's why Alex Ferguson at Man U has had to build up a team of ugly men who look like they'd be impossible to kill. Like Wayne Rooney. How would you kill Wayne Rooney? If you put a bullet through the middle of Wayne Rooney's head, all that would happen would be that he whistled when he ran. I wasn't surprised to hear that Rooney had to pay someone to have sex with him. I just assumed it would be his wife. At least he won't be remembered now for shagging a granny. Don't knock shagging a granny, because often they'll stick £5 in your pocket and say, don't tell your mum. They're worried it's going to distract him from his football. You could distract Wayne Rooney with a piece of shiny paper. I'm surprised they can get me chase after a ball without putting a bell in it. He's not the first footballer to have got in trouble with a 21-year-old escort. Stan Collymore got his cock stuck in the exhauster one. He just had a baby, hadn't he, Rooney? He must have been an asset at the birth. Look, Colin done a jobby with a fish. With the World Cup in South Africa, a very different World Cup because of the very real threat of HIV presented by the England team. Everyone was complaining about the vuvuzelas at the World Cup, the same decibels as a plane taking off. Why is it always a plane taking off? Why don't you think of something more original? The same decibels as Pavarotti getting his bell end caught in his zip. England folded under pressure. How can these guys feel pressure? These are men who can triple team a teenage hairdresser while their mate films it on a camera phone. I can't take a piss if the cat walks into the bathroom. Beckham was out there. Apparently they're trying for another baby, the Beckhams. Fucking hell, man. Shagging that woman must be like trying to separate deck chairs with your dick. What is it about people with cancer that they suddenly think they can run the fucking marathon? Oh, I've got cancer, gonna sponsor us. You feel like going, you have no chance of winning. I'm only joking, obviously. If you know someone with cancer and they want sponsored for something, please sponsor them. There's a good chance that you won't have to pay. I had a friend come up to me and say that she had breast cancer. She was going to cycle the Great Wall of China. Now, you can't say this, but you feel like going, you're the last person who should be cycling the Great Wall of China. You should be lying at home in bed, playing with your tits before they drop off. I should add, she doesn't mind me saying that. She's dead, she doesn't give a fuck. Not really, right? She doesn't even exist. It's a fucking joke. You can't take everything seriously. If we'd taken everything my gran said seriously, she'd still be alive today. Anyway, I do a lot of good work myself. I don't, it's another joke. I spend a lot of time helping teenagers who've been sexually abused find their way out of my house. Glad to see you made it. Thought I'd locked the cat flap.